Hi, my name is Loretta Hayes, and I'm from Hayes Sewing Machine Company. And welcome to our introductory series of how to use your sewing machine. We're going to show you how to thread a Singer Confidence Series machine, which is very easy to operate. So we're going to start out by taking and placing our thread on the machine. And you have a choice of doing it two ways. We can place our spool sideways on the horizontal spool pin, or in your accessory box you will have a vertical spool pin and felt that will insert into the hole on the top of your machine, and then we can place our thread going vertically. If we choose to place our thread going horizontally, then in your accessories you will have a medium spool cap and a small spool cap. And this is use your kindergarten skills. If you have a skinny spool, we're going to use the small cap. If we have a larger spool, then we're going to use our larger cap. So we're going to place our spool onto the spool pen, place our cap so that the spool cannot vibrate off. Once we have that done, we're then going to take the end of the thread and we're coming over to the first thread guide. The first thread guide actually consists of two guides, a small one and then a larger hook. Both of these thread guides can be pulled into, so we don't have to thread any small holes. So we're going to pull the thread into the first one and then simply take the end of the thread and go underneath the hook. You will notice on your machine a small diagram that shows you the direction that we want to go for rewinding the bobbin. So we're going to place the thread underneath the pin and go completely around it one time. The most important thing for you to do, you'll notice there's a spring load to this little pin. We want to make sure that the thread is seated well under that. If you take the thread in both hands and give it a little tug, it will seat itself very well. If you don't do that, then what typically happens is the bobbin, when you rewind, and it looks kind of sloppy and kind of uneven. So nothing's wrong with the machine, it just needs to be pulled in a little bit deeper. Now we're going to come over to the right side of the machine, and you'll see your bobbin rewind pin. Now when we go to thread, you'll notice on the bobbin you have a larger hole. So we're going to thread the thread through that large hole from the inside of the bobbin to the outside of the bobbin. Then we're going to place the bobbin onto the pin and just press firmly down and you'll feel the bobbin snap into position. Notice the arrow on the top of the machine. We're going to push the bobbin rewind pin over to the right. That engages the rewind. And if you hold on to the top thread, you can then step on the pedal and that thread will either spin itself off or you could stop and clip it with a pair of scissors. You can stop rewinding the bobbin at any point. So if you're doing a small job and only need a little bit of thread, you can go ahead and stop the bobbin with a small amount. However, if you want to do a larger project and you want to fill the bobbin, you'll notice the small bobbin stop on the side of the bobbin. And as we're rewinding the bobbin, the thread will start to rub against that and your bobbin will stop spinning when it's full. At that point, we're going to push the bobbin back to the left and take a pair of scissors and cut our bobbin thread. Grasp the bobbin firmly and pull up, and you have rewound your bobbin. To insert the bobbin into the bobbin area, we must first start by removing the cover. There is a black lever to the side, and if you take and pull it to the right, the bobbin cover will pop off. Simply place it to the side. We'll need that a little bit later. Then we're going to take our bobbin, and we would like the bobbin thread to be coming from the left. And if you notice, there's a picture on the front of your machine to help you with that. I always tell my students that the bobbin should look like a letter P, so we have the round and the tail on the left-hand side, as opposed to a number 9 where the round and the tail would be on the right-hand side. So look for the letter P, And once you have it, drop the bobbin into the hole. In the front of the bobbin case, there's a small slit. If you were looking at it as a face of a clock, it would be between 6 and 7 o'clock on the face of a clock. We place the thread in, and I place my finger on the bobbin so that there's a little bit of tension to the thread, and we're simply going to move the thread back to about 9 o'clock. At that point, you've actually threaded your bobbin. It's that easy. Now you'll notice on your plate there's a large slit heading towards the back of the plate. And at the very back of the plate there's a notch. So what we can do is we can take the thread into the slot, bring it around until we put the tail into the notch, and if you gently pull forward, it will cut your thread. The last thing to do for inserting the bobbin is to replace the cover. And you'll notice on the cover there's a small plastic tab on the left-hand side of the cover. You'll also notice that the cover is curved at the back and square at the front. So it's impossible to put this on backwards. We're simply going to take the tab, insert it into the left-hand side, have it at just a slight angle, and when we have the tab inserted, just push down. You're now done with your bobbin, and we're going to continue back up at the top of the machine to finish threading. When threading the top part of the machine, there are two things that are going to make your life easier. The very first thing is we want to thread the machine with the presser foot in the up position. So we're going to take the lever that's underneath the machine, and we're going to lift the foot into the up position. What that does is that loosens the tension discs that are actually in the slots at the top of the machine. And so as we pull the thread in, it will just fall into the slots with very little effort on our part. The second thing that we want to do is we would like to have the needle in the highest position. And the easiest way to do that would be simply to tap your foot control and let the needle go down and let the machine put it at the highest position. That way we know that the needle is in the correct position for threading at the top and also for using our needle threader. Now, back up at the spool, we're going to place our spool either in the horizontal or the vertical spool pen. The first guide is threaded the same as when we rewound our bobbin. We're simply going to pull the thread towards in our first section and then lay the thread under the hook and pull it towards us again. Simply follow the groove across the top of the machine, come down the front, and at the bottom here, right next to your reverse button, you will see an arrow that points up, and there's a number 3. So we're going to go straight back up, and we're going to see a number 4. This is the take-up lever that goes up and down to create your stitch. So we want to come to the right side of the take-up lever, go all the way back to the back of the slot, move the thread to the left, and then pull the thread forward on the left side. That automatically threads the take-up lever. There's no need for you to try and thread the hole anymore. Now follow the slot right back down the front of the machine. We're going to go down and we're going to find the guide right above the needle. And on the Singer Confidence series, there are two loops for this final guide. It's the larger loop that we're after. The smaller loop is simply there to give you a soft edge so that you won't get caught on the wire. The easiest way of threading this is to take the thread in two hands, with your left hand hand go up to the top, and your right hand you're going to pull it around the smaller bump and into the large bump. At that point, the last thing to do is to thread our needle. When threading the needle with using our needle threader, it is more convenient for us to have the presser foot in the down position. So remember when we were threading earlier, the foot was up to loosen up the tension. But once we're down to here, we can take the presser foot and put the presser foot down, giving us more room to use our needle threader. Now, when using your needle threader, the thread is vertical presently, For the threader to work, we need to have the thread going horizontally, sideways. So the needle threader, as it comes down from the machine, you'll notice two parts. There's a very large hook on the left-hand side, and when you tip the threader to the back, you will find that there are two metal prongs that are going to go around the needle. In between those two metal prongs is the little hook that's going to thread our needle for us. So as we're pulling the needle threader down, I like to take and put my thread on that larger hook on the left. I pull the threader all the way down, push the lever towards the back, and the two metal prongs are now surrounding the needle. We're simply going to take the thread, slide it up the front of the needle, and pull it a little bit towards us. When the thread is hooked on, you'll feel it. It won't move out from the threader. And then our final step is to pull the threader lever back towards us and move our hand towards the sewing machine. If we don't move our hand towards the machine, we're actually holding the thread from the threader. You can then release the threader. It will retract back up into the sewing machine. And our last step is to take the loop that's at the back of the needle eye and simply pull until the end of the thread comes through the needle. You can then take and place the thread under the presser foot with using the slot on the right-hand side of the foot. And at this point, you are threaded. You're ready to sew. So we can take our material and we can place that under the foot, place the presser foot down, step on the pedal, and we are off and sewing. You'll notice when we did the cutter on the bobbin thread, it cut the thread, and so it picked up the thread for us. We did not have to fish it up through the plate. Once you've done your seam, you can pull the thread out to the side, cut the thread on the cutter, and then place your fabric back in to do your next seam. Have fun sewing, and hopefully this will make threading a little easier.